Welcome to the Backstage Pass, where we take a look at the people, technology, creativity, and hard work that make your favorite movies and TV shows possible. With today's Backstage Pass, we'll take a look at American actor, director, and television presenter, LeVar Burton. LeVar was born on February 16, 1957. He began his film and television career in 1977. Early in his career, LeVar was featured in several film and television programs, but was perhaps most known for his portrayal of young Kunta Kinte in the 1977 classic, Roots. He would go on again to reprise this role in 1988 in Roots the Gift.
Come on, move! Move!
Kinte, are you to be a child forever? Were you not sent to catch a bird? Did you forget the instructions given you?
I did not forget.
Then you decided it would be better to disobey those instructions and...
I saw white men.
What did you say?
I said I saw white men.
His most notable role would come several years later in the Star Trek franchise, where he played Lieutenant Geordi LaForge in Star Trek The Next Generation. He would reprise his role as the visor-wearing engineer in subsequent films and television spin-offs.
I was caught in a fire once. I must have been, I don't know, about five, I guess. It was before I got the first visor. And it was only a couple of minutes before my parents found me and pulled me out. And nobody got hurt, but I tell you, that was the longest couple of minutes of my life.
Geordi was an homage. During the days when Star Trek conventions were first becoming popular, and Gene was, you know, he would go around and he would appear at these conventions, and one weekend he would be in Spokane, Washington, the next weekend he'd be in Cleveland, Ohio, and there was this young man in a wheelchair by the name of Jordan LaForge, who suffered, I believe, from multiple sclerosis. And Jordan and his mom, because his mom would bring him to these different conventions, Jordan was a huge Star Trek fan, just loved Star Trek. And Gene, over time, developed a relationship with him. And when it was time to, when he was working on The Next Generation, and he had made the decision to make the navigator, the man who flew the ship, was going to be blind, it occurred to him to honor his friend Jordan LaForge, who I think passed right around during that development period. And that's the origin of Geordi's name. He's an homage to a hardcore Star Trek fan.
While working on The Next Generation, Burton would go on to pursue passion for education and literacy, and gaining fans of all ages as the presenter for the PBS children's television program Reading Rainbow. On this program, Burton served as the show's main host. The show centered around educating children on a variety of different subjects. LeVar would cover a variety of different books that range from nonfiction stories to books that covered subjects of math, science, and literature. The show would also cover children, who would deliver brief book reports highlighting books that they enjoy reading that also tied in with the subject matter of each episode. The show would capture the attention of its young audience by breaking up each episode in two segments, where it covered the subject with live-action documentary-style footage and also illustrations and graphics from the various books referenced in each episode.
Hi there. I hope you're ready for an unusual adventure.
Reading Rainbow ran on PBS's children's television block starting in 1983 and would run for a total of 23 seasons. Over the course of its long run, the show would garner over 200 awards, including one Peabody Award and 26 Emmy Awards, 11 of which were for Outstanding Children's Series. 12 of the awards were for LeVar himself, being awarded for his role as a presenter of the television series. After the show concluded its final episode in 2006, Burton and his business partner Mark Wolf acquired the rights to the show and formed RR Kids, that is RRKIDZ, media company for children, reimagined as an all-new app aimed at children. This application became an instant success, becoming the number one educational application within 36 hours. Ensuring that the application meets high expectations, LeVar currently serves at RR Kids as the co-founder and chief curator.
Oh, maybe that's my friend. It is. Come in.
Hi. How are you?
So good to see you.
Is now a good time for a visit?
It's perfect time. Come I'd here. Like you to know my television neighbor, Mr. LeVar Burton.
Hi.
Please come in. I showed my friend some pictures of... Why don't we sit over on the counter?
Right. Oh, I see Mr. McFeely made the delivery.
He did. There's your book.
Okay.
I was showing them... Well, this picture of you with a book.
Uh-huh. That's me.
You love the books,
I
don't
do,
you?
I do. Wow, this one is old. This one was taken over 20 years ago. That's me, a long time ago, and this is my friend Louis Gossett Jr. This is from a television miniseries called Roots.
Oh, yes, and how well I remember that. All of you acting on that.
Ah, this is me as Geordi LaForge on Star Trek The Next Generation, and the character that I played, Geordi, is blind, and that's why he wears this visor. When he puts it on, he can see more than everybody else around him. He sees sound. Ooh. Geordi does.
So that's sort of magic, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
One of the things that made Reading Rainbow so special is how LeVar managed to bridge his two worlds together. On special episodes of Reading Rainbow, LeVar would break down the behind-the-scenes of movie-making magic. He even brought the kids behind the scenes to show the making of Star Trek The Next Generation. In these episodes, he would show everything from the prosthetics and makeup to the technology and science behind the show. Exposing kids to a variety of different subjects and career paths, Reading Rainbow became a huge influence for children over three decades. Showing his passion for philanthropy and community service, LeVar currently serves as a board member for the AIDS Research Alliance. He also continues to promote his passion for education and literature by hosting his own podcast entitled LeVar Burton Reads, where he covers a selection of short stories that he then reads to his audience. With a career spanning almost five decades and his passion for education and the arts, LeVar Burton continues to inspire children, leaving an impact for nearly half a century and for many years to come.